want to say this, guys, the musician is much, much more important than anybody else in the song, whether it's a singer or anybody else. So I think we really need to shout it out for all the musicians of this. And that's what a band is, it's a team. So when you're talking about 98, Nirmaka, in 98 also, when we were getting launched, it was important. Everybody, I think most of you might not know, I'm a medical doctor by profession. मैंने वही पढ़ाई कर रखी है गाना वाना मुझे एक्चुअली आता नहीं है सिंपल फ्लूक है दैट्स द ओनली थिंग आई स्टडीड फॉर सो इन मेडिकल यू नो व्हेन वी सिट डाउन एंड वी रीड मेडिसिन द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वे ऑफ मेकिंग एन इंपैक्ट ऑन एनीबॉडीज साइकी इज एक्चुअली ऑडियो विजुअल यू नो ऑडियो वर्क्स विजुअल वर्क्स बट इफ इट्स एन ऑडियो विजुअल इट वर्क्स द बेस्ट सो यू नो यू वी इट वाज वेरी क्लियर टू अस आल्सो दैट यू नो म्यूजिक वीडियो इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इफ यू रिमेंबर There were great videos at that time by Lucky Ali.
Absolutely.
There were fantastic videos by Silk Root. KK made lovely videos. Everybody was making great videos before Bollywood came and took them away. कि चलो अब हो गया, तुमने अपने लिए पैसे बना लिए, हमारे लिए पैसे बना लिए. So that's what happened. But for me, it was very clear at that time also that it was important to make music videos because we live in a country that has been bred and brought up on film. The only way to compete with it is to show something that people understand. And people in this country understand the entire song and dance, some story. So what Euphoria tried to do in 98 was, every 5-minute video of ours was actually a story. It was like a film. We were not thinking of content as you. We were not thinking of content. We were more interested in doing music for the love of music. It was not about ki main kitna famous ho jaunga aur main kitna ameer ho jaunga. It was just for the love of music. And I can just tell you this, guys, with a lot of conviction, that most of us who started off at that time, and I can definitely talk about all the first sitting over here, we all do music because we love music. Fame and money are like collateral damage, I would like to say. So we do it for that. And it was very clear then that making a music video that communicates with people like a film, like a story, like a part of your lives, this was extremely important. But yeah, times change, the management comes in, money guys come in, and then suddenly everything becomes content. Content to make money, primarily. Which is what is happening in this country. Again, I'm not saying it with any grudge. I'm saying it with conviction. It's not a matter of any kind of arrogance, it's a matter of fact. So we actually are living in times where everything is secondary. The most important thing is how to make money. I don't agree with it because I still would like to do music and I'm still doing music for the love of it, for the passion of it and without getting sold out to Bollywood or any of the other platforms. That's my take on the entire thing.
Thank you so much for that insight, Palash. I'm going to come back to you again. But you know, you've given a nice view from back in the day and how, you know, music was...
So back in the day.
Just
because I'm the only male on this panel, you can't bully me and say back in the day.
Ritu, now, you know, Palash has spoken about, you know, how things were back in the day, 98, when he made music because he loved making music. I'm sure you make music because you love doing that, but the way they conceptualize and they, you know, understood video was very different. For you, video and music is content, correct me if I'm wrong. Do you see it as content first and something that you know, that's something that has more of a creative cell, or it's content first for you?
I think it's not fair to put everything as a content just because it's on YouTube or any other social media. But I think when it comes to content, it's just like churning out things on a daily basis or, you know, have some consistency. But when you have a different take on it, say I do a rendition of a song, I just don't cover a song. So I think that's where the creativity kicks in, and that is the differentiating part that I would not like to consider as a content, but something that I love to do and just mash up the both worlds, I guess, the content and the creativity.
Right. Does it bother you that people call you a content creator and not a musician or a singer-songwriter?
I think always. I mean, firstly, I am a musician. I just took the route of a social media thing to start with. So I think, yeah, I would like to be called as a musician.
What a beautiful point there. Musician first, it's just that the medium happens to be social media and hence she gets called a content creator. Akriti, you know, we've seen how, you know, you've had a beautiful sort of transition from being, for people who are not aware, or for all the millennials and the generation after that, Akriti released her first album in 2010. Contemporaries, yeah, those are the least, yeah. I was a big fan when Akriti, your debut album came out in 2010. A big, big, big fan. And I've seen how you've, you know, excelled at playback. And now Akriti is somebody who has her own IP, if I might call it, which is called Big Bang Theory, where she realized that, you know, she wasn't getting her creative, she wasn't realizing her creative potential just being a voice in movies. She wanted to do something of her own, so she, you know, put together this concept called Big Bang Theory, where she does songs her way, shot her way, just the way she envisions them to be. So Akriti, from somebody who started independently, became the voice, you know, of actors in movies, to now coming into your own and claiming a new space. Tell me about how video has been so important all throughout.
Where to start with? The times that inspired me to get into music were the times that I was watching your videos, buying those audio cassettes back in the day. And that was the time when mujhe laga ki yahi karna hai. उस टाइम पे नॉन फिल्म पॉप म्यूजिक की साउंड बहुत अलग थी, जो इंडी म्यूजिक था उसकी साउंड बहुत अलग थी, और मुझे वो करना था. मेरा इरादा कभी भी एक प्लेबैक सिंगर बनने का था ही नहीं. फिल्म के गाने हम बाय डिफॉल्ट सीखते थे, पर वो करने का मेरा वो नहीं था, इंटरेस्ट नहीं था. बट बाय द टाइम आई केम टू मुंबई, दिस होल शिफ्ट हैड हैपेंड. एंड नॉन फिल्म के जितने भी वॉइसेस थे, लाइक यू सेड, हैड ट्रांजिशन इनटू बिकमिंग फिल्म वॉइसेस. So I was lost. I said, अब मैं क्या करूँगी, you know, and I am just a nobody from Delhi. School खत्म करके मैं मुंबई आ गई हूँ. Who will, the whole industry was waiting for Akriti Kakkar to arrive to Mumbai, कि भाई आ गई है, इसको सब फिल्म के गाने दे दो. So I knew I did, it wasn't going to happen immediately. So I started doing remixes, and that is when I realized the power of video, because however well those remixes were sung, it really hurt me how I hadn't even sung any one of those by then, but I saw nobody used to turn the CD around and see kisne gaya. We're not saying by singing remixes, you're doing some, you're not demeaning the song. Video might be whatever, it could be a kanta laga, it could be whatever, I mean, from that time, from back in the day. But I realized how video had become so important. So ab kya zariya hai mere paas? Ab mujhe music videos banane honge. So I started with a remix album, and that's how it all began, and then I sang a lot of remixes. Meanwhile, film songs record hone shuru ho gaye the, fortunately. A lot of people did show faith in me. Himesh Ji, Shankar Ehsaan Loy, a lot of people, Preetam Da. And that's how the ball started rolling. But what I really wanted to do was to be known as an independent artist who's a pop star in India, you know. But also then I realized that iske liye bahut courage chahiye aur bahut support chahiye aur ek thodi backing chahiye khud ke dimag mein.
Courage kaun sa chahiye, if you can just elaborate on the
courage? Because you know, when you are typecast as a playback singer in this country, I feel labels happen very, very soon and very, very easily here. So if you start as a playback singer, you know, to make that shift into anything else, to become a composer, or to become you know, if you want to start playing the guitar and just do that, people are not going to be accepting you immediately. So that change for me did take a lot of time. Even when my first album, it was a self-titled album, came out on Sony Music, when that came out, we won a lot of awards for it, but I'm still a playback singer who did a non-film album. So, you know, I mean, there were videos to that. It made me happy, but at least there was a vent that I found for my creativity, and not just, see, it's two different things, and they both are very challenging in their own way.
Right.
Singing for films was challenging because of playing a certain different character in somebody else's shoes. And then when you're doing your own music, I remember Shankar Ji had told me, when I told him, aap please mere compose kijiye, he said, I'm not going to do it. You compose it yourself, because it's about you wanting to tell your audiences what you are all about. So I think that opened a lot of doors for me in my head. But then again, I was back to doing film music.
Right.
A lot of playback songs, teamed up with performances, and then you mentioned Big Bang Theory. So this whole chapter of reaching out to YouTube, making my own recreations, revisiting songs that are close to my heart, I started a series called You Choose I Sing on social media. And we started to pick songs that were most requested and also happened to be of my sensibilities. So we recreated those, and my phenomenal, lovely One Digital team who's sitting here were all, you know, super supportive. They've churned out this whole, all these videos that you've seen. I didn't know this would work or not work, but I thought it was high time for me to tell everybody that I want to sing this too. You know, even if I'm not getting to sing a certain song, right, I want to sing it like this.
Right.
So this is what I tried to do, and we've tried to create a lot of videos from no subscribers to 220k plus, I think, right now. I got my simple 800k
yesterday. Big round of applause.
So thank you to you guys. And also, talking of Big Bang Theory, creating IPs, I think, for any artist is very important today. You know, if you have to put your voice out there, you have to move yourself and do it and not really worry about log kya kahenge, iska kya hoga, is pe views aayenge, nahi aayenge. Main bhi bahut dara karti thi. But I mean, it happened with the right kind of support from One Digital and my management team, DNH.
Jinke
bina, I think wo log baith ke mujhe bolte the, yaar, kar le yaar, dekhi jayegi. You know, just do it. We're with you, just do it. So I think you need to surround yourself with the right kind of energies, right kind of people who should also tell you ye karna hai aur ye nahi karna hai. So yeah, I think then you've got your road set.
Right, right.
GP, good person.
Great, I think it's really important for people to find their own dream teams and excel in whatever they want to do. Janita, you know, like they say, or they've always said since the 80s that video kills the radio star, you know, all that jazz, and there have been debates since then. In your peculiar and most beautiful case, here was somebody who had a video first strategy, okay, from any, like my first brush with, I discovered Janita from when she was just a YouTube player. She was, you know, doing your covers or whatever, renditions, and I knew as a YouTube star. And then one fine day, you know, heard Janita in Bollywood, and you heard her, you know, voice in Bollywood. And now, it's been so remarkable that, you know, just yesterday we were discussing how, by the way, Janita's new song is out today, which is Dil Ka Telephone.
Dil Ka Telephone, everyone check it out.
Now, the fun thing that has happened, we were talking about how she's gone from being somebody who was the face of her voice, so when she was on YouTube, she's the face, she's the voice, to becoming somebody who became the voice of somebody else's face. And now this whole journey from being in that space to claiming your own identity all over again. It might have taken you, what, 5 to 6 years? Tell me about that.
Yeah, I think identity is a great point to make, because I feel that all these things that we're doing is a great way for us to find our own identities. I just want to rewind a little bit to the content creator thing you guys were talking about. I don't know, maybe I'm seeing it the wrong way, or I'd like to think I'm seeing it the right way. I think content creation and being a content creator is actually a very empowering term. I like that title, because I think it's a way for you to have no bounds. You can make whatever content, everyone's calling it. I would equate content creators with artists, period. Because I don't like being labeled as singer, or actor, or dancer, or model, or whatever it is, right? I have this bimari of wanting to do everything. I think a lot of us have that.
It's a great bimari.
We want to try our hand that, you know, we are creators, we're creative people. And so we don't like being kind of placed in boxes. And so I think that's a very cool thing, that these days there's so much overlap and the lines are being blurred. So, yeah.
Awesome, great. You know, since we're talking about content creation, the previous panel that was here on stage discussed, you know, content creation and the media and the entertainment business at great length. And one of the statements that stuck with me were made by Ashish Bhaseen from Dentsu, who said that it's not a content game anymore. It's a data game and it's a technology game. So tell me about now, you know, in 2019, how much is technology, data, feedback from, you know, your audience or your team, in your case, you know, the able hands that, you know, that you're working in making sure that your numbers are up. How is and how often is that impacting your creative process, Palash, from your end?
Okay, so main to pehle se ulti taraf hi ja raha hu. Hum log to sab kuch khud hi karte hain. So we Euphoria.
He directs his videos himself.
So I direct my videos myself. We write our own music, we compose our own music, we play our own music. Eventually, we are only hearing our own music. So we are doing pretty much everything ourselves. We have good person backing us. I meet him once in about 2-3 years, but that's a different issue. Let me just make this taking from what Jonita also said. See, the thing is, the only thing constant in life is change. There's, there has to be change.